Students, among the human skeleton system, today I am going to discuss about skull. Yes, skull, where skull is present, we all know that skull is the topmost portion of the human skeleton. See, this is the peak of a skeleton, means our bone, our brain is protected through this skull. This is the diagram of an entire skull. And it is made up of 22 bones. Yes, skull is made up of 22 bones. And these bones are very strong and hard. So, skull is the topmost portion of the skeleton system and made up of hard and strong 22 bones. And these bones are joined with each other through sutures. Or suturis, okay? These bones are joined with each other through suturis or sutures, means they are immovable joint found in the skull. Thus, bones of the skull are joined each other through these sutures, means this is entire, not a single bone. It is made up of 22 bones, and these bones are joined with each other through these sutures. Okay, among the skull, these are the upper jaw and this is the lower jaw. Lower jaw and upper jaw. Upper jaw and lower jaw both bears teeth. Yes, the jaw bear teeth. So, how many jaws are there? Two jaws, upper jaw and lower jaw. Just follow the diagram. Upper jaw and the lower jaw. When this upper jaw is fixed, the lower jaw is movable. Suppose when we eat and chew the food, this upper jaw is movable. This is the lower jaw. Upper jaw also bear teeth, lower jaw also bear teeth. This lower jaw is movable, means it can move. So that's why we can talk, we can chew, we can eat food easily. So these are also the part of a skull. One of skull is to it protects the brain. The skull is made up of strong and hard bones. That's why it protects the brain. Also, it holds eyes, ears, tongue. Eyes, ears, and tongues. So, this is the function of the skull. The skull is the uppermost portion of the human skeleton system, made up of 22 bones. These bones are very strong and hard. Actually, the main function is to protect the brain, eyes, ears, and tongues. Upper jaw and lower jaw, they are also the part of skull. Both bear teeth. The lower jaw is movable, and that's why we can eat our food, chew, we can talk easily. Okay, and these bones are joined with each other through sutures. So this is the skull. Now the second part of the human skeleton system is the vertebral column. What is this vertebral column? Vertebral column is located at our back portion. From the neck region, means from the base of skull, and it extends up to our hip region. Okay, this is an elongated structure, and it is also made up of how many bones? 33 bones. This is made up of 33 bones, and these bones are 33 bones are connected with each other through cartilages. These bones are connected with each other through cartilages. This vertebral column is also called backbone, as it is extends along the back portion of our body. That's why it is called backbone also, vertebral column or backbone. But this vertebral column is so flexible, means it can easily bend in this way. In general, it is straight, elongated, but it also can bend, and means this is very flexible. And for this reason, we can easily bend our back. Okay? So, vertebral column is very flexible. Now, this vertebral column's function is to support the head region. This vertebral column supports the head. And in between, there is a cavity or a channel. In between this vertebral column, there is a channel or a cavity through which the spinal cord is present. Okay? In between the cavity of the vertebral column, means just a pipe-like structure, in between them spinal cord is present. So this is the vertebral column. The vertebral column is present along the backside portion from the base of the skull and extends up to the hips. It is made up of 33 bones and these bones are connected with each other through cartilages. Okay, this vertebral column is very flexible and that's why we can easily bend our body or bend our back. So this is the vertebral column. Okay.